परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाश मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री चित् घन गणेशाय नमो। यम सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वेन अपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम महः तदेव अहन्नमत्तोन्य इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Okay, so the next avarta says dhana dhana sangaja dukkham. The dukkha born out of association with dhana. Dharapatyadikam parityajya dhanameva kaanshato mahattaram dukkham. So there are people who are not interested in family life or anything, you know, associations with others. So they are not interested in getting married or anything like that, but then they are interested in wealth, fame follows later, but dhana. So for them also there is mahattara dukkham, not a small dukkha. So this, I mean, it as a shloka, as a subhashita. So here in Srimad Bhagavata, what is mentioned, that is said here. Arthasya sadhane siddhe utkarshe rakshane vyaye nashopabhoga ayasas chinta brahmo nrunam steyam himsa nrutam dambha kamakrodasmayod madaha medo vairamavishwasaha samspardha vyasanani cha ete pancha dashanartha ह्यर्थमूला मतानृणाम तस्माद् अर्थम अनर्थाख्यम श्रेयोर्थी दूरतस्त्यजेत। सो टू एक्यूमुलेट धना, टू ग्रो धना, टू प्रोटेक्ट धना, एनी ऑन इट्स नॉट इट्स सती सप्तमी। सो इन द एक्यूमुलेशन ऑफ धना, इन सक्सेस इन गेटिंग वेल्थ, इन ग्रोइंग वेल्थ, इन प्रोटेक्शन and on vyaya, on depleting, the wealth depleting, there is dukkha. Dukkha is there. Ayasa is there, and dukkha. Ayasa is dukkha rupa. Therefore, it's a brahma, chinta brahma nranam. And if it is stolen, all of this, I mean, not necessarily stolen, a person may steal because of wealth, desire for wealth, dharma may be discounted. Therefore, steyam himsa anrutam dambha, lying, himsa is involved, thievery, dambha, kamaha, krodha, all of these follows with dhana. In fact, in I think Taittiriya Upanishad bhashya, under the mantra on in the Prathamavalli, in Prathamavalli, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says there is an order. So there is a refrain of, you know, for dhana, there is a homa prescribed for dhana, and there is a mantra japa prescribed for medha. So medha, Saraswati and Lakshmi both are needed. However, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says the order is medha first, then dhana. Otherwise, one who has dhana without medha, he is led to ruins. Therefore, medha is needed, and it is mentioned to be attained first. One should get vidya first, and then one should go after dhana. So here it is said, you know, otherwise, if dhana is there, dhana or the desire for dhana is preceding the accumulation of vidya, then all of these can be a possibility. And there are these 15 are listed here. Ete pancha dashan anarthaha. There are 15 adversities अर्थ मूला, फॉर विच द मूला इज अर्थ धन, दिस इज कंसिडर्ड नृणाम फॉर पीपल. तस्माद अर्थम अनर्थाख्यम, अर्थ इज अनर्थ रियली बिकॉज इट लीड्स टू अनर्थ, इट इज मूल फॉर अनर्थ. Therefore, one is who is shreyarthi, one who wants moksha, should give it up. How? Durataha. One should not even try it. Otherwise, it will trap a person. That is the idea. Bhidyante bhrataro darah pitarah. Bhidyante bhrataro darah pitarah sahrudas tatha. Ekas nikdha kakanina sadyas sarve arayah krataha. Of course, this should be chanted without padachyeda. But then I don't want to repeat it. Therefore, arayaha, arayaha, aris are enemies. Who are the enemies? All these bhratara, dara, pitara, all of these suhrudaha, friends, enemies, relatives, cousins, brothers, everyone, even parents are mentioned as becoming enemies for one who is desirous of wealth. And kakanina, you know, by the desire for a coin, a mere coin, that is how it is mentioned here. Arthen alpiyas saapyete samurabdha deeptamanyavaha tyajantyasun mithognanti sahasotsrujya sauhrudam labdha janma labdha janma amara prarthvam labdha janma amara prarthvam manushyam tad Dvijagretam. So here, Manushyam, Dvija, all this is mentioned is leading to Amruta. There is a possibility of Amruta in this very life. And having attained that kind of Janma, one shouldn't go after Dhana. So, Tad Anadritya Ye Swartham Dhanti Yanti Ashubhangatim. So, Yanti Ashubhangatim, they attain Ashubhagati. Those who give up the Manushya Janma and having been endowed with Dharma Shastra, becoming Dvijas, they do not respect that, which is the reason they have taken Manushya Janma, and instead of that, they fall for Artha. Swargapavargayor dwaram prapya lokam imam puman dravine kvanu shajyeta मर्त्योनर्थस्य धामनि कस्मा संश्लिष्यते विद्वान व्यर्थयार्थे अर्थहे अर्थेया सकृत कस्यचिन माया नूनं लोकोयं सुवि मोहितः इति श्रीमद् भागवते एकादश स्कंदे त्रयोविंश अध्याये भिक्षु गीतायाम उक्तम. सो भिक्षु गीता, भिक्षु इज अ सन्यासी. So this is a song of a sannyasi who says that I want moksha, therefore I have given up all of this. Why would you want all of this if you want moksha? So that's the idea there. Dhanam hi arjane, dhanam hi arjane, vyaye rakshane, hanau cha dukkhameva. You have seen this. So dukkhameva vidhatte. One attains dukkha in accumulating wealth, in growing it, in protecting it. And when there is loss also of dhana, there is dukkha. अनवधिक धनार्जन आसक्त पुरुष निरवधिकान पापान आचरति. वन हू वांट्स वेल्थ, यू नो दे से दैट द वेल्दी, द मोस्ट वेल्दी, यू नो व्हाट यू कॉल अ स्टिंकिंग रिच, इफ यू इंक्वायर इनटू द बैकग्राउंड देर इज अ गुड पॉसिबिलिटी, देर मे बी वन ऑफ एक्सेप्शन, देर इज अ गुड पॉसिबिलिटी दैट दे रीच देर बाय पाप, बाय ईजी मीन्स one can earn a decent livelihood, maybe up to luxuries also is possible with decent life, with dharmacharana. But even that is difficult today. If you look at it, a simple, I mean, need not go further. I'll just talk about myself. I don't want to talk about others. So after my engineering, I was offered marketing jobs. I was never interested in sales and marketing because I knew inherently it's a job of lying. You can't tell whatever is happening in the company. You have to sell the product by exaggerating. Exaggerating is arthavada. So far it is fine, but then you have to lie. As a tech support, I have seen that when I used to interact with customers, because I was servicing the product, medical equipment, this person who has sold has committed things which the equipment is incapable of doing. So many times I have seen it. So it's a lie. People lie through their teeth to get work done. And this is the simplest of the jobs in each and every aspect of life. In fact, I think somewhere in Bhashya, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, Grahastha, even in during his time, mind you, during his time also, he says a Grahastha has difficulty to follow dharma in its entirety at times. So he hints that there is some kind of lying involved, because one has to accumulate anna. In Taittiriya Upanishad itself, we said, I think there itself, somewhere in around there in the last valli, Bhrigu valli perhaps, or Brahmananda valli, maybe Bhrigu valli, towards the end he says that. This is what I remember. I may be misplacing the Bhashya from elsewhere. But he says that, you know, it's difficult to live a completely dharmic life. That's why we have prayaschitta karma. Nonetheless, so niravadikan papan acharati purusha yaha dhanarjana asakta. One who wants to accumulate wealth, keep on accumulating, that is the only goal of life, then one does not, and I don't care. The person will say, I don't care what I do. This is my end goal. I have to reach my target by hook or crook. Nanartha bhajanancha bhavati dhana sampadana pravruttaha jati kula dharman stejati. And this is something which is, you know, known. I mean, it does not even come as a surprise, let alone a shock. Jati, what is a jati dharma, kula dharma, all of these people don't even know, let alone follow. Because dhana sampadana. And this is where Bhagavan Sringeri Acharya says this. He says, at least, okay, I can understand that, you know, in dharmacharana, maybe you think that you cannot earn a decent livelihood, and whatever your targets are, fine, you have to work. At least do not give up your sandhya. So then he says that people ask him as to, could you give us some shortcut method for sandhya? Okay, whatever sandhya morning you do, when you go to office, before that you do your sandhya. But it takes too long, you know, could you give us a, you know, bare minimal what we can do and basically get away with that? He says, okay, what is the problem? You can't spend 15 minutes, half an hour in your sandhya, but you will watch a 2-3 hours movie. You'll every day you don't watch movie, let's say, but you will watch news. You'll read newspapers. For that, you have time. You have time to while around in all sorts of things except when it comes to dharmacharana. So what does that tell us? Jati kula dharman stejati. Because the commitment is elsewhere. And this is not for an individual, some particular thing. This is for masses. That is how it is. This is how the fact, people don't even know what is Sandhya Vandana. Pooja Swamiji used to say the Yajnopavita, what is the job of Yajnopavita? And most of us may have seen it. Yajnopavita is there. What is it for? To scratch your back. That's all. That is the use. Unfortunately, even for a Brahmana. Others even don't even wear Yajnopavita. They have left it long back. Even Brahmanas have unfortunately given up. Anyway, because dhana has, artha has become the primary goal of life. And what is that artha for? Not for dharma. One may say, okay, there are people I know of. I want to accumulate wealth. Why? Because I want to do dharma karya. Now, this is something I have also gone through. I don't have to pinpoint others. I would like to have wealth to do some dharma karya, because dharma karya is, unfortunately, dharma is falling. Because the dharma karya, those institutions who are supposed to take care of them, those are being looted by, we need not mention that. We all know. Whereas the other religions are flourishing. In the same Sanatana society, unfortunately. So dharma has to be protected, you need wealth for that. But then in the pursuit of wealth, the dharma is lost. Very unfortunate setup, but that's Kali Yuga for us. नाना घोर कर्मणा धनार्जने प्रवृत्त अपि स्वपूर्वादृष्टायत्तम एव धनं लभते नाधिकम्। नाउ दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट, प्रारब्धाय समर्पितम स्वपु, दिस इज दी ज्ञानी दृष्टि। नाना घोर कर्मणा धनार्जने प्रवृत्त अपि, प्रवृत्तौ अपि, वन हु इज एंगेज इन एक्युमुलेटिंग वेल्थ, एंड दिस विल बी नोन फॉर अ स्पेसिफिकली फॉर वन हु इज इन परस्यूट ऑफ मोक्ष। You can't get both. Very difficult to get both. I won't say impossible, but next to impossible. Because the focus, if it shifts from moksha to dhana, even in nishtha it shifts, then there is a slip. There is a chuti, there is a fall. If one is accumulating wealth, even with all resources at one's disposal, still स्वपूर्वादृष्टायत्तमेव धनं लभते, वन विल गेट धन विच इज ड्यू बाय प्रारब्ध, ड्यू टू प्रारब्ध, एंड व्हाट इज दैट प्रारब्ध, इट इज कार्ड आउट ऑफ योर ओन कर्म। सो हाउ मच एवर एफर्ट यू पुट इन, यू विल गेट ओनली एज मच एज यू डिजर्व, विच कैन बी अ लॉट ऑल्सो, विच कैन बी मिनिमल, विच कैन बी इवन निगेटिव धन। यू इंडल्ज गेटिंग धन, यू लूज इट. All that is because of Purva Drishta. This should be very clear. One may take efforts, but then this is Karma Yoga. I mean, this Karma Yoga, one gets only that much, not only dhana, anything that is due to you, nobody can deny it. And how much ever effort one puts, one will get only that much, na adhikam. One cannot get more. Vyaye sati dhanam kshiyeta iti bhitya na swabhogayapi ishadapi dhanavyayam karoti. There are people who are misers, although they have enough wealth for generations, still they wouldn't spend it, because if you spend it, that amount, that number decreases. So, kintu mahantam klesham anubhavan nana kumar gaihi taddhanam vardhayan neva mriyate. So, they can't enjoy the dhana. After them, whoever takes over that dhana, they will enjoy it, but these people, they accumulate wealth, they don't spend it, and then if they have not spent it, they have not used it, they'll live a life of misery and die in misery. Svabhogaya va paropakaraya va viniyoge asati yadi daiva vashad dhanam nashyati tada apare shokasagare nimajyati. And if one is not using it for oneself or for others, and if for due to some reason there is dhana nasha, then there is apara shoka. Ittam dhanam ananta dukkha karanam bhavati. Therefore, dhana also leads to ananta dukkha. If one utilizes for others, be it in family members or a better cause also, the other's happiness will bring happiness, but they don't have that. इत्थं सनिपुणं विचार्य भर्चुः धारापत्य धनाद्यभिमानं दूरीकृत्य वने एकाकी सन् शमदमादि साधनाभ्यास निरतो बभूव। सो फाइनली साधु हैज लैंडेड ऑन भर्चुस वैराग्य, हाउ इट लेड टू वैराग्य, एंड देयर बाय भर्चु गेव अप ऑल ऑफ हिज लौकिक परस्यूट्स and engagements, duri kritya vane ekaki san, being alone in the vana, shamadamadi sadhana abhyasa nirato bhavuva. He engaged in shamadamadi sadhana, basically shamadamadi shatka, and viveka vairagya already attained. That is the reason he is going to the third step, which will make the vairagya stronger, and thereby they'll build upon each other, and then finally mukshatvam. The next avarta, 240th avarta, says, now this story is connected back to where it started. Long, long back, before the Vairagya Prakarana, Bharchu is the Amatya, the minister, prime minister, who was favored by the, he was capable, of course, he was favored as per the others, he was favored by the king, and therefore they took care of him. They tried to take care of him completely, but they couldn't. So, he has retired to the forest. Now, the king goes on a hunt. एंड दीज पीपल हु हैव रिप्लेस द प्राइम मिनिस्टर भरचू दे नो दैट देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी दे नो अबाउट भरचू दे केप्ट एन आई ऑन हिम एंड दे नो दैट दिस फेलो इज स्टिल हैंगिंग ऑन इन द फॉरेस्ट सो इफ द किंग सीज हिम आई मीन वॉट ही वुड डू टू अस वी कांट इवन इमेजिन सो देर बाय They have to cook up something. So the background here is Mrugayartham Vanangato Raja Bharchum Drishtva Bhitav Palayate. The king, they built up a background story such that the king wouldn't even recognize Bharchu and run away from Bharchu in fear if the king sees him when the king goes on a forest trip. So what is the background there? Bharchu, Bharchu Sthanapanno Mantri, Bharchu Rattantam Sarvam Shrutva, Swanuyayi Bhihi Saha Evam Samalochayat. So he heard this minister, the replacement minister, he heard about Bharchu and then he called a Sabha of all the villains. So they got together. And then he said, Yadi Raja Bharchu Jivati Iti Lokavartam Shrunoti Athava Mrugayartham Vanangatva Swayame Bharchum Pashyati Tada Mithyavadinaha Asman Saharaja Sutikshnam Dandayet Iti. So he saw this part. The king would punish us if he hears about the stories about Bharchu being alive doing the rounds or if he himself sees Bharchu. Therefore, evam alochya, having thought about this, saparivaro rajanam asadhya dasyubhi yuddhe mruto bharchu pishacho bhutva bhasmodhulita sarvango vane sancharati. So they cooked up a story, a horror story saying that Bharchu who was killed by the others, the miscreants, the robbers, has become a Pishacha. So we hear this, that he has become Pishacha and he Vasmodhulita Sarvangaha Vane Sancharati. And he, you know, he roams around as a Pishacha putting Bhasma on his body. So be careful if at all you see him. This is what they warn the entire family of Raja. Sadrushti gocharapannam sarvam janam marayati. And then he is going to kill everyone, anyone and everyone that he sees. Yastam drushtva saduram palayate sajivet. One who runs away is alive. Iti vijnapayamasa. This is how they taught the king and his family. They fed some false stories. Mantri vakya shravanamatrina raja tattvam avicharayan. Now this is where tattvam avicharayan. Because this story has been brought about for what reason? We have to link it together. We have taken a good trip in Vairagya, but which should actually Vairagya is coming back from all the trips. So after Vairagya, how do we connect this? What is the virtue becoming Pishacha, virtue being killed? What has that story got to do with Vedanta? First of all, the background there in the Vairagya, Vivekadi, Sadhana Chaturte Sampatti has been brought about by the Bharchu Katha. Second thing now he is going to, what Sadhu is intending to do is connecting this back to the question of Adrishti. Who is a Madhyama or a Adhama Adhikari? What is being said is, even a person who has Jnana, what kind of Jnana? Which isn't Sthira, which is not Manana Siddha. Even if it is Manana Siddha, there is no Nishtha. Then what happens is that some person tells you something. Basically, indulgence in the world. If one continues to indulge in the world, then that Mithya Jnana, Mithya Prapancha can still become real. Due to lack of Viveka, it will eat away your Viveka driven Vairagya, Shamadi, Shatka Sampatti, and Mumukshutvam will go for a toss. Because a person who has Jnana Matra as Paroksha or Aparoksha even, but still the Aparoksha Jnana where Nishtha isn't there. Doubts may not be there, may or may not be there, but there may not be Nishtha, which is why the earlier pursuits continue the way they are. Then it will lead to a fall. This is Jnana Rakshana. This calls for Jnana Rakshana, which Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya talks about, which is not talked about often, because people think that Jnana is there, that is done. Jnana is there is a big question. We have to ask ourselves whether Jnana is there, whether it has resulted in change in me. If my Antakarana continues to be dragging, get dragged along with the Indriyas to the Vishayas, because the Vasanas continue to keep me as a Jiva, then Nididhyasana is not going to be possible. And no amount of Shravana may work well unless one is going back and keeping a check on Shamadhi, Shatka Sampatti. If it eats into Viveka, Vairagya and Shamadhi, Shatka will not be possible. In fact, the Bhagavan Sringeri Acharya, Chandrasekara Bharati Mahaswamiji, talks about this in Viveka Chudamani Vyakhya. In the Vyakhya, he says that he links up the Sadhana Chaturte Sampatti after the Jnanutpatti and reinterprets each of the words in the Sadhana Chaturte Sampatti, especially the Shamadhi Shatka. There is an Uparati word there. The Uparati word and Shama are quite close. It is reinterpreted after Jnanotpatti as Sannyasa, Samyak Nyasa. It need not be Ashrama Sannyasa, but one has to withdraw from activity. This withdrawal from activity is something that people have trouble with. They can balance both. Balancing both is Trishanku Avastha. Those who have tried, they know. But one may find oneself in a place where one has to balance. Try to balance out. But still there should be sannyasa there in attitude. So one has to withdraw. Shamadhi Shatka should be kept in check. Otherwise Viveka fails. It indicates a failure of Viveka, which shows that moksha will be bahuduram. Because you cannot have an akarta doing all karmas with passion in the sense wanting the results. So that is the check that one has to make here. And this is connected back to say that others feed you something, meaning whether the indulgence by yourself or you are dragged back into society, then interacting with them, even a jnani matra will have a fall. So that is said here. With the story, it is connected back at Mantri Vakya Shravana Matrena, just listening to the others. This Raja does not know who is Apta anymore. He has lost. So in the exemplified, one has lost the insight into what Shruti and Guru Vakya means. One goes with the others who are Ajnanis or the Prapancha which is Mithya, and starts giving it value, Shobanadhyasa, which is what we saw in the Prakarana which went by, Dhana. Shobanadhyasa for Dhana, Shobanadhyasa for Stri Purushadi, as based on whichever gender one is. Putradi, and then it can be extended. That is Upalakshana, it can be extended to anything and everything that one values other than Atma, Atmajnana. Thereby, Tattvabodha, I mean, the first step for the sadhana is the Viveka. And what is Viveka? Nitya-nitya vastu Vivekaha. Nitya-anitya vastu Viveka has to be there. And what is that? That is explained as what? Nitya vastu ekam brahma eva. Tad viparitam. और तद व्यतिरिक्त व्हाटएवर इट इज नीड नॉट बी लिटरल सर्वम अनित्यम. सो ब्रह्मात्म व्यतिरिक्त सर्वम अनित्यम एव दैट इज द विवेक. बट स्टिल इफ वन इज इंडल्जिंग इन दैट अनित्य एंड इट्स अनित्य ऑल्सो इन विवेक चूड़ामणि व्याख्या देर इज स्टेटमेंट अबाउट इट सम वे से ओके इट्स ओके अनित्य आई एम नॉट लुक आई नो इट इज नॉट नित्य सुख बट इट इज अनित्य आई एम ओके आई गेट सुख बीट अनित्य आई गेट अनदर यूनिट ऑफ अनित्य अनदर यूनिट ऑफ अनित्य एंड कीप ऑन गेटिंग अनित्य सुख दिस इज दी कर्मकांडी टू हूम दी वेदांति से स्वर्ग इज अनित्य स्वर्ग इज सुख रूप. सो पूर्व मीमांसका सेल्स इज फिलोसॉफी सेइंग दैट एवरीवन इज लुकिंग फॉर स्वर्ग. Even if you say you don't want Swarga, you want Sukha. And Sukha, Swarga means Sukha. It need not be another loka. There need not be a travel involved. If you are looking for Sukha, you are looking for Swarga. Thereby, Swarga is needed. Swarga is the goal for everyone. This is the Purvamimamsaka stance. Vedantin says that your Swarga, whatever Sukha, let it be Sukha pursuit here and now. All that is Anitya. He says, I'm okay with it. I'll go to Swarga. I'll have Sukha. I'll come back. If you do not want to go to Swarga, you'll have Sukha here. You'll come back. You'll have more Sukha. If you give up Adharma, you continue Dharma, it will give you Punya. You'll avoid Papa. You'll keep on getting Sukha. What is the problem? I don't have any issues, he says. There, the Vyakhya helps. Oh, you think that is Sukha, but it is not real Sukha. Mithya sukha, it is not sukha at all. So anityattvam, if you are okay with, it is equivalent to saying the example given by Bhagavan Vyakhyanakara there under Viveka Chudamani is that the, if someone wants something, if one wants to be an emperor, so there the example is given, I want to be an emperor. Okay, you will become an emperor, but in your dream. So that's how you know you have a phrase in English also, in your dreams. Meaning it's not going to be possible. Or it is all fake. It's all kapola kalpita. It's all imaginary. Becoming an emperor is not going to be possible. So if someone is told that your sukha is like sapna sukha, sapnavat mithya. Not anitya, mithya. So it is not going to be real at all. And mithya there has a sense of false. It does not mean sarasadhyam anirvachaniya. We can say that also, but it is not the way you think it is here because it is not Vyavaharika even. Vyavaharika Sukha is Mithya. Then the person may start inquiring into it as to why the Nityatva has been mentioned. So it may take away Viveka. So here it says, Mantri Vakya Shravana Matra Raja Tattvam Avichare. And this shows the lack of Viveka. He does not inquire into the reality. He just goes by what appears to be true on the face of it. Mruto bharchuhu pishacha samabhavat. So he has become pishacha iti nischikaya. He was sure about it. Now let me be careful. Tatak kadachit akhetartham gato bharchu vanam pravivesha. Tatra तरुमूले तपश्चरंतं भर्चुं दृष्ट्वा प्रतारकं मंत्री वाक्यं. So this is मंत्री वाक्यं. प्रतारकं मंत्री वाक्यं स्मरन. This is what is called as Brahma. So Brahma there, the result, because of Smriti there is Brahma. Oh, he saw this Bharchu who was doing tapas. And having seen this Bharchu who is doing tapas under a vriksha, when he went to the forest, the king recalled the mantri vakya. Oh, he has become a pishacha. Let me run away, otherwise he is going to kill me. Noonamayam Bharchu pishacha iti bhayena palayita. So this much is the story there that he ran away. So ayam arthaha. Anyway, this artha, I think we'll skip this part. We'll skip this part. This is about dhana. We have already gone ahead. We know this has been covered. So the only some parts may be there. I'll just read it. Ayam artha artha sampadane vardane cha ati dukkham rakshane mad dukkham. We understand this. Vyaye bhoge cha mahati chinta nashe chitta bhranti अर्थ प्राप्ते स्त्यादय षडनर्थाः प्राप्ते अर्थे स्मयादय षडनर्थास् त्रिविध व्यसनैः स नवानर्थः तस्माद् एकोऽपि अर्थः पञ्चदशानार्थ अनर्थानां निदानं भवति सो हाउ इट कम्स अबाउट टू 15 दैट इज शोन हियर व्यसनानि स्त्री द्यूतम् अद्य विषयाणि त्रीणि व्यसनास् दे लीड टू व्यसनास् धन हाउ वन इंटेलिजेंस इन मोर एंड मोर You know, because resources are available, one may not be able to control kama. Dyuta, one gets into gambling. Madhya, liquor, etc. So all these are vyasanas. So all three will become addictive. Eka snigdha eke eka prana ha. Te cha asnigdhas chat cha atipriya ha ityartha. So atipriya, eka snigdha is atipriya, that is the meaning. काकणी ही इत्यार्षम पुंस्त्वम सो दिस शुड हैव बीन नॉन पुल्लिंग इट हैज बीन यूज्ड एज पुल्लिंग दिस इज आर्ष प्रयोग सेज द टिप्पणकार काकिणी काकिणी ही काकिणी और काकणी ही विंशति विराटकाः सॉरी विंशति विराटिकाः विराटका वराटका नाउ आई एम सॉरी आई डोंट नो दिस वर्ड आई लुक्ड अप समथिंग आई डोंट रिकॉल नाउ वराटकास Actually, some reference is given. So, Vimshati, there are 20. Vimshati, Varatikaha. Varatakanam, Dashakadvayam, Yatsa, Kakini. See, we don't know these, I don't know these numbers of the coins and which were used. But anyway, it is all, meaning is all seen as the coin, finally. Iti, Lilavatyam, Samurabdha, Shubitaha. Mithah parasparam. So it is meaningless. It's not of such value. Even for a coin, they fight. That is what is said here. Mithah is mutual. Spardha iti pati spardhamana ityartha na kevalabhi haivanartham anarthahetur ityartha paraloke api ityaha. So na kevalam iha eva anarthahetuhu arthaha. So the artha is not anartha only here. It is also anartha in paraloka. लब्ध्वा इत्यादिना तत् मानुष्यं जन्म इति संबंधः द्विजाग्रतां ब्राह्मण्यं सो दैट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड देयर गेटिंग मनुष्य जन्म एंड अ बेटर जन्म बेटर इन द सेंस ऑफ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ मोक्ष बिकॉज द अपॉर्चुनिटीज आर मोर एवरीवन हैज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर मोक्ष बट स्पेसिफिकली ब्राह्मण बिकॉज ब्राह्मणस वृत्ति इज सेट टू बी वैदिक वृत्ति इफ वन फॉलोस ब्राह्मण्यम If Brahmanam is followed, it does not mean just by jati one does not get anything. But if Brahmanam is followed, one continues with Vaidika life, then the opportunity for moksha is more for Brahmana, which is what obvious. And this need not be, said as what kind of bias is this. It is not by bias, it is by karma. And every karma is paid here and now in Laukika also. Thereby, there is nothing wrong in saying that the janma being by karma and karma should get results, the janma will get results because it is based on karma. There is nothing wrong here. People who think this is wrong have misunderstood the karma theory itself. Swartham ghanti swaitam na acharanti. And why more opportunities? A person who is born in a family with both parents as doctors, who would doubt that that child has a better possibility of becoming a doctor because guidance is available at home. He has seen since childhood. So possibility is said does not mean definitely so. A possibility of more opportunity, that's all it is. Swartham granti swaitam na acharanti lokam deham. Anyway, so just for completion, I read that. I think it is clear. We have seen that. So iti bhayena palayita, this Raja has run away. Bharchu drishtantasya prakrutena yojanam. What is the importance of this Bharchukata? We have gone all around. We got the Sadhana Chatushte Sampatti. But the Viveka lacking is shown here. How does it connect with the Prakarana of Adrishti's question regarding Moksha being possible by Shruti and Guru? And in the context, why it seems, why is this story has been brought about for Adrishti by the Acharya. So Sadhu wants to show that you Tattvadrushti was being taught. You were also there. Adrushti, your brother has already got moksha. You are lacking. Why? You have already got the same jnana that they got. In Kathopanishad, it is said, the mantra says, there Bhagavan Bhashyakara explains that mantra. The same patha is going on. There are many shishyas. The guru teaches the same Upanishad to everyone in the same manner. There is no special treatment in a class, in an open class. Assume that. In that case, how is it that Tattvadrushti got exactly what was taught? Adrushti did not get what was taught or got a little, and then some may have got something opposite to that. Some may have got something which is on a tangent to that. Some may have not understood at all. All these possibilities exist based on the adhikarityam or lack of it. So here the sadhu wants to show by this story that you who have jnana because Tattvadrushti was taught and you were also taught. You who already had jnana are finding it difficult to inquire into and thereby later hold on to. So you have to work on sadhana chaturte sampatti. That is shown by the Bharchukatha with the Vairagyadi Prakarana. And the Raja is not inquiring and goes along with the things which are apparent as facts. Similarly, this prapancha appears to be real. All this that you are finding difficulty with, as seeing as mithya and landing on jnana, holding on to jnana, that is because of lack of inquiry. Vicharam na sahate. Maya will not stand scrutiny. You have to inquire into Maya and Maya karya. Somebody cooks up a story that the world is real, you go along with it. And who is that somebody? Each and every person around the child who is born is cooking up a story, including your own indriyas, that the world is real. Because pratyakshatvena pramanam. But that pratyakshatvena pramanam does not work there because swapnavat mithya. That has to be taught. Thereby, drishyatvat satyam is not true. Drishyatvat mithya has to be taught. So what is the connection there with the Bharchukatha of the Siddhanta? Pratarakam mantri vakya satyatvena grindhan. Raja vane jivantam bharchum swas chakshusha pashyannapi. Even if there is jnana, which is aparoksha, that is the exemplified. Even if there is aparoksha jnana, still you miss your, because atma is ever aparoksha, still one misses it. Even after being taught, one misses it. That's why it is the best kept secret. An open secret, everyone knows about it. Everyone talks about tattvamasi, but talking about tattvamasi, one, it does not enter one's nishtha. So swachakshusha pashyannapi, in the exemplified we should understand this as even after the jnana is aparoksha or getting jnana, not nishtha is lacking, then we say aparoksha, but we'll say obstacles have to be removed, or we say it is paroksha. Pratarakasya mithyavakye vishwasena bharchum pishacham eva manyamanu yatha suduram pradravat tatha dvaitinam bhedavade vishwasan aparipakva matihi ajnani tattvamasiti guru upadishta mahavakya janya sakshatkara rupa brahmatmaikya akara antakarna vrtyudaye api bhedavadino mithyavakya vishwasena mahattaram dukkham eva anubhavet. Brahmatmaikya akara. So brahmakara vritti has taken place. Vrityudaye api. So sakshatkara, which is said to be sakshatkara, should have been sakshatkara, even if that jnanotpatti aparoksha jnana has taken place, still being around this bhedavadis, dvaitis, dvaitinam bhedavade vishwasan, assuming all this bhedavada to be true, which one has taken to be true before jnanotpatti, aparipakvam matihi ajnani, this ajnani was aparipakvamati, he is an ajnani before the teaching. Initially he was, everything that was taught to a person, the child growing up, in its entirety the life has taught only dvaita. Across lives one has not known anything other than dvaita. Therefore this ajnani who is aparipakvamati, why aparipakvamati? Because dharma acharana is, if at all it is there, it is for phala. It is not karma yoga. It is not without the akanksha of phala. So chitta shuddhi is lacking, that is said by aparipakvamati. Then tattvamasi iti guru upadishta vakya janya, that sakshatkara which is by jnana of aikya, which is born out of mahavakya taught by the guru, which is tattvamasi ityadi. We can add adi also, not necessarily only tattvamasi, but any mahavakya which leads to aikya jnana. Guru upadishta mahavakya janya sakshatkara roopa brahmatmaikya akara antakarana vrityudaye api. So there is a brahmakara vritti due to this aikya jnana. Even then, bhedavadino mithyavakya vishwasena mahattaram dukkhameva anubhavet. This is something that people don't talk about. Oh, this aikya antakarana, you know, people say brahmakara vritti has taken place, everything is done. Oh, it is not done, sir. It is a beginning of the journey of the sadhaka who has become a jnani, jnani matra. That's why gradations of jnani. And this is what Bhagavan Bhashyakara says. Even before this, once you know that there is, the prapancha is mithya, you withdraw. He talks about sannyasa, which is ashrama sannyasa. But let's just say, at least withdraw. Reduce your mithya indulgence. Indulgence in mithya means that you do not understand the word mithya. If you withdraw, it will give a better opportunity for nishtha, for jnana prapti, jnana rakshana, and in nishtha. Else, the world will drag you down to its own level. There is no way that you interact with your, all those who you think as ajnanis. You may think that I am ajnani, everyone around me is ajnani, they don't understand, and I can handle it. No, you can handle it. The you who can handle it is a karta. That itself is a first trap. I can handle this world is a trap. The mind cooks up these ideas. Antakkarana has vasanas. They want opportunity to manifest. Even if you are practicing nishtha, they will have an opportunity to come out and you can cleanse them. Otherwise, they don't even get the opportunity to be cleansed. They get an opportunity to trap you. This is the setup. Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says that this is letting the mind play the role of the police, mind itself being the thief. Mind is a thief. You ask the thief to play the role of a police, it is a veshadhari. Will do nothing. Will trap you, steal from you. So it will steal your sadhana, chatushte, sampatti, viveka, vairagyadi, then shamadi, shatka sampatti, all of that. The mumukshu who considers himself as jnani will not even remain a jnani. So Bhagavan Krishna calls the karma of a jnani as karma bhasa. One who is a paripakva matihi, even if he gets that sakshatkara and considers that I am okay any which way and lands on following the same things again and again, will be dragged to that level, and his jnana will be jnana bhasa. It will not be karma bhasa. This karma is not karma bhasa. It can be. That is how Shastra says, for a jnani who is paripakvamati, not aparipakvamati. Therefore, the prakarana of sadhana continuing Shravana continuing, Manana continuing, and that is possible only in withdrawing from the social indulgence with the same intensity, at least initially. At least a little you withdraw. And in fact, it's a fact. The more you get taste for Vedanta, the taste for the worldly will drop off. Has to. I know of people, I mean, couple of my students had earlier, they had mentioned, one person he had mentioned that, I don't feel interested in social interaction, but then I have to do it. There is no intensity to interact. I don't feel like, you know, having parties, going to parties, going to anything, you know. Even when people come home, there is no common ground to discuss. So you superficially discuss something because you have to play the role. But then given a choice, I would like to avoid that also. So one has to look for that choice, whether I have that opportunity. And Bhagwan Bhashyakara says that this opportunity, why shouldn't you miss it? Is because not only in this life, even in another life, you do not know whether you will get this again. You don't know what your prarabdha is going to be in the next janma. You don't know your sanchita. Right now, you know that there is an opportunity. Take a step back. You have been given this opportunity. If you don't take it, carry on. But then don't expect that jnana will stay. That is why the gradations of jnani. Na tasya kadapi brahmatmeke sakshatkaro bhave. So this is the issue there. So what here it has said? Mahattara dukkha, and thereby we just look at Udayapi Bhedavadino Mithyavakya Vishwasena. If one continues with the Vishwasa in Bhedavakya, Mithyavakya, that presents Bheda, comes about life, then Mahattaram Dukkham Eva Anubhavet. For Sukha Prapti, one has to withdraw. Na tasya kadapi Brahmatmeke Sakshatkaro Bhavet. So this Brahmatmeke Sakshat, what does it mean? This antakkarana vritti has taken place, but sakshatkara has not taken place. Why? The sakshatkara rupa aikya is known in the vritti, but then one can't hold on to it because it is kshanika. Vritti goes away because other vrittis are given more importance, and thereby what is the risk there? Na tasya kadapi brahmatmaikyo sakshatkaro bhavet. We can be a little lenient and say this bhavet is ichharte vidiling. Ichharte ling we can say, and say not as a na bhavet means we need not say that impossible, but almost impossible. There is a likelihood that he will not get sakshatkara. Bhedavadam asatyataya grinnato jidnyaso eva mahavakyat brahmatmaikyatva sakshatkaro bhavet. Only one who is a jidnyasu, one keeps on inquiring into the reality and thereby lands on mithya bhedavadam asatyataya grinnata. One who understands the mithyatva nischaya is complete, then mahavakyat brahmatmaikyatva sakshatkaro jidnyaso eva bhavet. Therefore, manana siddha it should be, and nishtha should show that. Tasmad avaidikatvad bhedavado mithya. Because bhedavada is avaidika, it is mithya. Na parama purushartha sadhaka iti nischitya tatra vishvaso duri kartavya. Mithya prapancha is not going to lead to parama purushartha. Therefore, one has to keep it away. The vishvasa in the Bhedavada should be kept aside. So that is the 241st avarta. We'll continue with the mithya samsara dukkham mithya upayana nivarteta iti etan upapadanaya kachana katha. There is another katha taken through which, because just, you know, the direct statements have already been given. Mahavakya and such have already been given earlier in the 4th chapter. These have not worked for Adrishti. Adrishti needs a better methodology. Just like in Chandogya Upanishad, Shweta Ketu kept on asking, Punareva, Punareva, Vijnapayatu Bhavan, Bhagavan. So please teach me again. Not repeating the same thing. People who think that it has to be repeated in the same, it has not gone well the first time. It may not go well the second time. But that Navakritta Upadesha, Nine times Sattvamasi has been taught, but not with the same manner, with a different example, different approach. Something will click. That is a prakriya bheda. Each time there is a refinement of the understanding till finally no questions remain. Same thing is happening here. If one aspect is clear, the other isn't clear, something else has to be used. If the same aspect is not clear, then another prakriya may work. So through katha it is revealed here, Bharcho katha is over. That was all it was. So Raja A has run away. And what has been said here? Brahmatmaika sakshatkaro kadapi natasya bhave. So Raja never understood who Bharcho is. He always thought that Bharcho is a pishacha. He did not get that Bharcho has become a muni. He is really alive. This is how a person who indulges in dvaita will end up in. I'm sorry. Anyway, let's stop here. Let's continue in the next part. Sukhan nityam svaprakasham vyapakam namarupe adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher ketna nirmana aparam sarvedant vedyam pratyak paramah tadev ahannamatvanyat iti me nischitamatihi. That's it. Any questions? Just landed back on Vedanta.
Thank you.
Okay. Namaste.
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 Hari Om.